Why is scarcity important in economics? Scarcity is essentially the notion that resources are available in limited supply. All resources are scarce, though it depends on the context from which you view them, as they may be scarce in some contexts, but not in others. Asterisk If resources weren't scarce, we could create an unlimited amount of anything we knew how to make and many things we don't even try to make, for lack of resources. But that's not the world we live in. Meanwhile, economics, at its core, is the study of how best to use those limited resources. Frequently, economists try to optimize relatively opaque notions of utility or well-being, given that the inputs required to produce these notions are limited. In super basic terms, economics is an academic attempt to put the world's limited resources to their best use. Put differently, economics is the attempt to make the most of the scarce resources at our disposal. All economic problems stem from how much of a given resource exists, and how they are spread out around the world universe. In the near future, we will likely mine resources from asteroids and objects from beyond our planet, so we will end up reevaluating what is and isn't scarce. To get back to your question, fundamentally, without scarcity, there would be no need for economics because we would have an infinite supply of anything we could imagine available immediately for no cost or trade-off. Asterisk An example of this context is that there is plenty of water in the universe, but we can only really access the water on the planet Earth. Time is scarce, in that, as of now, humans have limited life expectancies, but it's not scarce in that grand tasks like the building of the Great Wall could be tackled by many workers. Scarcity is not important in economics. But inherent, or existing naturally pre-birth. But, you can rephrase your question into, why treating scarcity as important in economics or hence, dealing and tackling it? Scarcity is what brought economics as an important social science subject to existence in the first place. We have to deal with scarcity of resources to produce yet insatiable demands from society which assume to be in greater quantity than the producers can produce. We have to find the best possible ways to find equilibrium point at which, the economy produces the most with the best inputs and productivity and wisely and efficiently to fulfill the demand from the society as desired. In reality and also, in theory, not all desired demand will be able to be met by economic production, all due to this scarcity issue. Yet, it is the main goal to find on the demand curve a point where the society is at peace with the supply produced though it doesn't satisfy all the wants, with logical burdenless price and enough quantity to cater the basic needs of the society. Abundance is the engineering answer to any resource question, and austerity, scarcity is always the answer given by monetary system administrators who want to make themselves artificially important. It's hilarious to hear that we have need of economics, the management of our monetary systems. Proven failed theory is fiction. Supply and demand are not causal indicators and nor is GDP, stock market performance, left and right, disposable income, nor most of the reports economists have used to prop up political careers and wealthy sponsors. Corruption comes from criminal intent or academic incompetence equally it seems. Engineering and science faculties need to take this critical faculty back now because economic imbalance is expensive and it's dangerous. Both finance and business are proven unsustainable, which of course was how they were designed as well. We could be asking Harry Potter or a monkey with a dartboard for his opinion on policy and we'd be further ahead. If economics is a social science that studies how individuals, governments, firms and nations make choices on allocating scarce resources to satisfy their unlimited wants, then I would say that scarcity is fundamental in economics.